Back here at home, severe tropical storm Florita triggered massive flooding in Bagao, Cagayan. For more on the situation on the ground, we are joined by Narciso Corpus, the head of Bagao's Municipal Disaster Risk Reduction Management Office. Good morning, Sir Narciso. Thank you for being with us on the show. So first off, what's the latest situational report gathered from there? What kind of calls have you been receiving? How many are currently stranded, hurt, missing?
Come again, ma'am.
What kind of calls have you been receiving on your end? How many are hurt, stranded, missing?
As of now, there are no residents stranded, but of course, there are still evacuation in our evacuation center, ma'am.
Okay, so let's ask first how the weather is looking as we speak. What areas are you closely monitoring? Risk of any landslides?
For now, our weather is already okay. We are just worried with our bridges. Our bridges located our bridge located at Bagunot Bridge, which is still underwater right now.
All right, we'll get to those bridges later on. But how are your communication lines and power supply so far? I assume they are doing a little better since we are able to reach you.
With regards to our communication line, we have still problem with regards to our internet connection. With regards to our electricity, some of our barangays in this municipality is still no current. We have no current until now.
Ano pong mga area ito?
Various barangays po. Yung mga barangays namin na wala pang kuryente. As of today, itong hit po ng munisipyo, yung barangay San Jose, generator pa po yung ginagamit namin dito sa munisipyo, ma'am.
Balik po tayo dun sa evacuation centers natin, no? Sige po ba, nasusunod naman po yung pandemic protocols? At nakakarating naman po ba yung donations nyo?
Yes, ma'am. Nag-ikot kami kagabi together with the municipal mayor and the Sangguniang Bayan members, including the vice mayor. Okay naman po with regards po sa pagkain nila. Wala namang problema kasi namigay ang mga ang barangay officials ng mga pagkain, relief goods, and pati na rin po yung ating municipal government ay nakapagbigay na rin po kami kagabi ng mga relief goods, and ngayon po nasa
I think we have lost Sir Narciso, nandiyan po ba kayo?
Yes, ma'am. Yes po.
Okay, nandiyan pa po. Kumusta po yung mga impassable roads natin? Kanina po nabanggit niyo yung Bagunot Bridge po, no? Na submerged pa rin po. Ano pa po bang ibang bridges natin na hindi pa rin nadadaanan, and meron po ba tayong alternative routes na open?
For now po, ang submerged na bridge namin ay yung Bagunot Bridge namin, na kung saan ginagamit kasi ito ng pitong barangay. For now, wala pang alternate route. So yung mga barangays natin, residents natin residing sa pitong barangay ay hindi pa nakakalabas. So ang ginawa po namin kaninang umaga, nagpadala kami ako ng rubber boat. As per instruction of the mayor, nagpadala ako ng rubber boat para magamit po in case of emergency.
Ang schools po natin, sir, suspended pa rin po ang classes. What about offices?
Meron pong order ng ating provincial government governor for the suspension of all levels, private and school po, and sa work po at resumes na po yung pagpasok po ng mga government employees na po natin ngayon.
Okay po. So wala na pong pasok. And what protocols are in place po ba? Kung sakali lang na lumala bigla po ulit yung panahon, ano? And how prepared is the province's deployment of rescue efforts? Should there be people stranded sa mga landslide and flood-prone areas?
With regards po sa COVID-19 protocols po natin, ay sinusunod naman po namin. Actually, kasama namin ang Municipal Health Office na pumupunta sa ating mga evacuation centers para may patapat po natin yung mga protocols. Kasama din po yung Municipal IITF po to ensure that the protocol on COVID-19 is being implemented.
Mm-hmm. Okay, lastly, going to give you this opportunity po to call for help. Ano po bang pinakakailangan ng province nyo right now and paano po kami makakatulong?
For now po, ang kailangan po namin ngayon yung mga relief boats na doon sa mga stranded or nasa evacuation center. Yun lang po. Ang isang malaking damages po kasi namin is yung crop damages. Madami pong nasira rice and corn.
So infrastructure po, agriculture. Mm-hmm.
Yan po.
Okay, on that note, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Per initial report of our Municipal Agriculture Office, mga 70% po ang damages po namin sa agriculture. Most especially sa rice and corn po.
All right, well, we'll continue praying for the best. You stay safe po and stay dry, sir.
Thank you, Pam. Thank you.